Soul Families, Breanne here. Thank you for joining me today. If you're new to my channel, welcome to Readings with Breanne. I had somebody request a tarot dive on Johnny Depp and whether or not he's going to make a career comeback. So I thought that would be kind of fun to dive into. I mean, many of you guys are probably familiar with that. The Depp and Heard trial from back in, 2022, that was quite an interesting thing to observe and watch. And I believe the outcome of that, last time I read, was it was more in favor for Depp than I believe he was awarded, like $10 million in damages. So kind of it was leaning more in his favor. And now I guess he's on to new ventures. But I took a look to see if there was any upcoming movies, and it looks like he did release one just May 2023. He released that Jean de Berry. I'm not sure if I'm saying that 100% correctly, but I mean, I have not seen it. That being said, it is a French movie that does have some English subtitles. But this is the first time that I have heard of that movie. So, I mean, has Depp burned bridges? Is he going to make a comeback? I mean, we'll have to pull some of the energies and see what's going on. But energetically, I feel like he will continue on, and he will, you know, keep making other movies or directing movies. But somewhere in terms of that, I don't see him stepping down and retiring just yet. So let's dive into the tarot and see what the energies are for Johnny Depp. All right, so let's take a look at what the momentum is for Johnny Depp. I don't see him, you know, out of, like, intuitively, I don't see him out of the spotlight. But maybe he's going to move on to other ventures, like more behind the scenes, say, like, as maybe like directing. I think I did read somewhere online as well that that's what he was, I think, focusing on. But okay, so the question that was asked was, will Johnny Depp make a comeback? So let's just take a look and see what's going on with Johnny Depp and the future of his career. I'm going to pull some oracles here as well. What is the energy of Johnny Depp and his career moving forward? Oops. Well, we have that Venom energy here. And the Offering. Interesting. Ooh, I didn't even see that one. The Gem. All right. So that King energy in the background as well. I feel like he's like removed a lot of toxicity from his life is what it feels like. So we've got that Page of Wands, the Temperance, Ace of Cups, Eight of Swords, and we have the Ten of Cups energy as well. Three of Pentacles in the back. So he's definitely not, you know, I don't feel like he's retiring here. I feel like this is him collaborating and working more and more with certain individuals in the film industry as well. Now, is Mr. Depp going to be making a big comeback, such as a big movie, such as the Pirates of the Caribbean? I don't know based off of this energy. I mean, like I said, I definitely don't see him scaling back and quitting altogether, or let's say retiring. But there is this energy with this page here. This page is kind of, I feel like, him scaling back on certain adventures or certain projects that he's working on. It's more of a balanced approach here. So, I mean, not to say I do see him possibly making some more movies, but it feels like a sense of him maybe working a little bit in the background, maybe doing some directing. I think they mentioned when I was reading, he's kind of changing his, you know, his projects more to working behind the scenes. But overall, it's like this energy of much more being roles that are much more balanced here as well. Starting kind of off with this Page of Wands energy, I mean, you know, it's kind of interesting. Like, I don't want to jump over to this Eight of Swords yet, but there could have been some bridges that were burned along the way and with this whole trial coming out. But overall, it's like he's got this offering card and he's the king in the gem energy. So he's like this diamond in the rough. I mean, he's definitely born for stardom here. I mean, he's already famous. So with his offering, I feel like he is being offered certain roles and he's going to be involved with certain ventures here. But this page is, I feel like, again, maybe a change. So I don't know if we're going to be seeing, you know, similar kind of movies. I mean, like we just did that one recent one that came out last year, but it was that French-based movie. So something a little different than, I think, his usual role that he plays. But overall, it seems like with this Temperance and even the Ten of Cups, there's something about, you know, him taking part in things that are more emotionally fulfilling and balancing in terms of where he's headed on his journey. But I do see him, you know, making a bit of a comeback, but in terms of him getting as big as that big, you know, Pirates of the Caribbean box office fiasco, I don't necessarily see that happening. I feel like this is kind of a scaled back energy. Now, if we look at this Venom energy as well, there's that feeling of, I feel like he had dealt with definitely lots of toxic energy over these years, especially with that past relationship with Miss Heard, definitely a toxic relationship. So there's this sense of like freedom right now. It's like a breath of fresh air and he's like putting things behind him. He's moving forward. So he's letting go. He's leaving all the old baggage behind and he's starting fresh. And he has like a success here. So I really don't see him going anywhere. I think he's absolutely passionate about making movies or directing or acting. Like this is his true passion. Like he absolutely, there's a lot of love for what he does here. But there is an energy of him kind of scaling things back a little bit. But with that Three of Pentacles energy here as well and the Ten of Cups, he's gonna have some successful projects coming out. I do see them being quite big, but just not like major box office hits. And I mean, he is also that king energy there. So this is that king, that emperor energy. I feel like that's pertaining to lots of leadership as well. I mean, on the more darker side, I mean, this could be him abusing his authority or his power, which I feel like he possibly could have done in the past. But I, you know, he's got this temperance. He has this light lifted energy about this reading. So I feel like the darker times for him are definitely of the past and he is looking forward to like a more lighter, brighter future is what it seems like. What do we have for Mr. Depp and his career? Yeah, look at that. We've got the sun, lighter and brighter times for him here. So definitely like that Three of Pentacles as well, he's going to be giving more and more to projects that I feel like are more, oh, I don't know, up his alley. I mean, not to say the other ones weren't, but you know what I mean? There's a bit of a feeling of this energy of he could have been giving his energy to the wrong people. Yes, look at that. Five of Cups in reverse. This is all about letting the past go and moving forward to the brighter future here. Six of Pentacles. Yes, a beautiful give and take here. You know, it's kind of interesting because bottom of the deck, we have Two of Wands. It's like despite this trial and all the things that have come out, I feel like he still does have lots of support here and there is going to be work for him. So it's not like he's out of the picture and his career is doom and gloom. He is making a comeback, but not to the extent of like major big box office is what I feel like. I do feel like he's going to be successful and we will see more of him. But especially with that Two of Wands, so he's planning, he's working, he's getting things out there. So there is a project that could be quite big. So big, but not, you know, top of the box office Pirates of the Caribbean big is what I'm getting. Let's pull a couple more cards here. What do we have? What is the general energy of Mr. Johnny Depp? And I mean, it seems like, especially with this Ten of Cups energy, it's this feeling of like, it's a success, a celebration here, but I feel like he's going to hold certain things more near and dear to him, and he's going to be fulfilling things that are more emotionally fulfilling. So he's not just going to take a part because that's good money. He's going to take something that he is really emotionally invested in here. And I feel like he's going to get many offerings to do additional things or additional films. But again, there's a sense of him working behind the scenes, more in terms of movies, so I guess directing would be kind of where he's headed or where he's going. Actually, and even that two of wands energy is kind of giving me a bit of a director's energy. Ooh, interesting. We have Walt Disney. Okay, so anyway, this movie says, is it cute? Does it sing? That's the way you make cha-ching. Pull at heartstrings, hold the purse strings, the happiest place on earth charges admission. But there was something also with the I just had to Google here. So it says there was something about Disney, because not speaking so much about this guy, but in terms of Disney, Johnny Depp, because that was the role that, with oh my goodness, Pirates of the Caribbean, that brought him to so much fame as well, one of his biggest movies. But he said he would definitely not go back. And look at that, we've got that Five of Cups. So he's moving on to other things. And there was that statement, he said nothing on this earth would convince him to return to Pirates of the Caribbean. So kind of interesting that that card came out. That's so crazy. So he's definitely, he's set in, he knows what he wants, and he's not going to, that's what I mean. Like, there's nothing, there's no amount of money, there's nothing somebody could do to get him to go back. So there's something going on in terms of that situation, but it's that feeling of him moving forward. He's letting go, he's moving forward to completely new things that are more in alignment with where he wants to go. Because I feel like a little bit of the spiritual aspect as well. It's like he's going to be more in touch with his inner thoughts, with his intuition, I guess you can say here. So I guess based off this, guess we have a no-go on him going back to, do any more work for, I guess, Disney in general, is what I'm getting. So I guess, there is some situations, some bridges have been burned. Not saying it's all on Depp's side, but there's definitely some things going on in the background. But that being said, he still has certain energies and a lot of, I feel like, support from other organizations here. What's the overall movement of Depp in his career? Oh my goodness. So that's crazy. We have blessings in disguise. So this hardship and endless cycles. So I feel like this is pertaining to the situation with her as well. It could be the situation with Disney. I don't know kind of the in-depths of what happened with Disney, but this is him. This is a blessing in disguise, and him moving forward to better things and things again that are more in alignment with who he is and who he's becoming here. I feel like just this uplifted energy coming from him and from Depp. But overall, I'm getting like a much peaceful life here. This is celebration, success. So I feel like he's enjoying the finer things, the simpler things in life here. But definitely, we haven't seen the end of Depp. He is going to be continuing, I feel like, to work in the spotlight. I mean, whether that's behind the scenes or on camera, I'm not 100% sure. I do get a lot of behind the scenes, but I am getting, in terms of him scaling back some of his roles a little bit, or just maybe working on, with this page energy, this is kind of working on maybe smaller projects in the future here. So it will really be interesting to see kind of what unfolds pertaining to depth in his career, but You know, I was going to end the reading here, but I keep looking at this Disney card, and I've been reading kind of conflicting things. I read in one statement, like where Depp says he would never go back to working, you know, there's no amount of money, and he would never go back to working for Disney or anything of that matter. But then I've also read certain articles or, you know, blogs talking about how Disney has apologized and offered him all this money. And then there was also this exchange of, I think, Depp even saying, well, you know, anything is possible. If it's the right project, I might be open to coming back. So let's pull a couple cards pertaining to this Disney situation, because really Disney is what put him on the map. That was that big franchise. That was what really took off with Pirates of the Caribbean. So let's take a look. What is the energy of Depp doing work with Disney in the future? Right, let's keep this Disney card. All right, Spirit, what's the energy of Depp doing work with Disney in the future? Will they be working together again at some point? Seems to be a little back and forth on some of those energies. Ooh, we got the star. This is him. Okay, coming to well, it's kind of interesting here because, I feel like there is a very much a potential for Depp to sign some kind of a contract with Disney or some kind of a project. That being said, I feel like it's not just going to be any old project. Just like Depp says, like if it's something that he's really passionate about, something that he really is interested in doing, depending on the role, depending on the theme, he may take the bait and he may go back to Disney. And in doing so, that's, you know, seeing certain projects, I feel like really getting out there. I do see him, you know, making a comeback. So this could be that bigger project that could be in the works. We have the star, so this is him acting as well. So I feel like if he is going back to Disney, I feel like he may take place in a role, an acting role here. So being on screen, but now we do have that tower in reverse. So what I'm getting based off this energy is like whatever happened behind the scenes, the accusations that Disney made against, you know, Depp here, I feel like there was definitely a lot of hurt, a lot of feel of betrayal here, especially with this. But this is him being able to like hold on to, it's like holding on to certain situations. Like if they were to offer him a role and it's like they apologize and, you know, yada yada, it's like all these things lining up for him, he will have the strength to take it and move forward. So kind of interesting, because at some point I think he did say there is nothing that could ever, you know, convince him of going back and working for them again. But based off this energy, I see him possibly going back and working with Disney. So again, there could be some apology, you know, definitely probably a nice sum of money to go along with it. But I do think this is if he's, I mean, I don't think he's gonna just go back for any reason. It has to be something that he's extremely interested or passionate about here. But this tower is kind of about holding on. This could be holding on to a situation, even if it's a bit of a disaster. So there was definitely that tower moment specifically with Disney, and I feel like there's a bit of a mending energy with this. Because he has the strength and the Ace of Swords. So this is clarity, new projects on the horizon pertaining to possibly Johnny and Disney. But it is kind of interesting because we do have that Five of Swords energy lurking around in the background there. So this is that energy of like possibly even walking away. So is he going to accept? I feel like there will be an offer extended, or I don't know. There could be an offer extended to him to do some work with Disney, but I wonder if he will accept it here. It depends how passionate he is pertaining to it, but I feel like there's also a lot of with that Five of Swords energy, it's a feeling of deception or feeling like a victim. So definitely lots of like hurt traumas pertaining to this whole situation with Disney. But I guess we'll see what happens. There is definitely a potential for him to go back and work with them in the future. Sending you all lots of love and light on your journey wherever you are. And until next time, bye for now.